हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक अगेन। माय सेल्फ अदुल हुसैन शेख, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑटोमोबाइल डिपार्टमेंट एलजेआईटी, एंड वी हैड ऑलरेडी डिस्कशन रिगार्डिंग फ्लीट मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम एंड बस डेपो स्ट्रक्चर्स इन अवर प्रीवियस वीडियो। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एम्बुलेंस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम्स एज वी नोन एज इज द एएमएस। देन सेकंड थिंग इज दैट 108 ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल एक्टिविटीज इज एडवांटेज इज बेनिफिट टुवर्ड्स द सुटेसी, एंड लास्ट वन इज द फायर ब्रिगेड सिस्टम। सो दीज आर द बेसिक थ्री पॉइंट्स ऑफ टुडेज लेक्चर। सो लेट अस डिस्कस वन बाय वन एवरी टॉपिक। फर्स्ट वन इज द एम्बुलेंस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम। सी, इट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सिस्टम ऑफ अवर डोमेस्टिक लाइफ, राइट, एंड इट डायरेक्टली डील विद पर्सन्स हेल्थ एंड इट्स मोरल वैल्यूज, राइट। सो लेट अस डिस्कस एम्बुलेंस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम। सो द एम्बुलेंस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम इंक्लूड्स transporting the patient from the incident site to the emergency room of receiving hospital for definite care, transferring the patient to another hospital for further diagnostics and treatment purposes. So this is the basic motto of the ambulance management system. See, ambulance management directly deal with the patient care, right, and ambulance directly deliver patient from accidental site to the hospitals, and while transferring ambulance provide basic medical treatment to the patient, so it can save patient life. So it directly deal in our domestic life as well as it shows their importance in our life. Okay, now ambulance management system refers to a formalized system, right, means it is a proper formulated system that document processes, procedures and responsibility for achieving the policies and objective of ambulance management system, right, means there are so many kind of documentations and formalities are there, and every nurses and compounders and ambulance operator have to face that, right. So at that time ambulance management system are totally responsible for deliver patient from accidental site to at hospitals, right. So it is the basic function of the ambulance management system, right. Nowadays we are so habitual of the ambulance management systems, and in all over India we are openly use 108 organizational activities, and organizational 108 organizational activity will very helpful in our domestic life also. Now let us discuss one by one ambulance management system. So in ambulance management system, mainly there are four pillars of the ambulance management system. First one is the ambulance staff, second thing is the ambulance standard, third one is the ambulance positioning, and fourth one is the ambulance operation. So these are the basic four pillar of the ambulance management system. In ambulance staff, mainly there are three person: ambulance operator means driver, second thing is the nurses or compounders, and third one is the assistant medical officer, right. So mainly there are three persons in properly ambulance management staff. Second thing is the ambulance standards, right. Ambulance standards is designed for, right, we can say that ambulance standard is designed for properly with helping to patient, right, for its basic treatment, medical treatments, and we can show that so many times ambulance is properly designed with oxygen supply, basic amenity supplies, first aid supply. So these are the basic requirement of ambulance. So ambulance are going to be designed as per ambulance standard. Third one is the ambulance positioning, right. Ambulance positioning is the main part, right, because so many times we have to face this kind of situation due to delay of the ambulance, patient was died, right. So ambulance positioning is most important task in ambulance management system. So we have to put and we have to locate some preferable location at which all corner of the resources or all corner of the CCs will get easily accessible, right. And last one is the ambulance operational, right. Ambulance operational system is reach, sense and care principles, right. Mainly there are three principles of I can explain you very next PPT, but mainly there are three operations: reach, sense and care, right. So these are the basic three operation of the ambulance management system. Right. So these are the basic four pillars: staff, standards, positionings, and operation. Right. Now let us discuss 108 organizational activities. 108 is a free emergency telephone numbers in 25 states and union territories of India. Right. The service was rolled out initially in Andhra Pradesh. The system was later introduced by nationwide for the former Union Minister Ramadas. Right. So this is the basic introduction of 108 activities. Right. Basically, 108 activities deals with these three parameters. First one is reach. Second one is sense, and third one is care. So these are the basic three pillars of the ambulance management or 108 organizational activities. Right. Sense, reach, and care. Right. And this is the basic 108 organizational ambulance. Right. See, sense, reach, and care is the basic motto of the 108 organizational activity. I can give you one best example of the 108 organizational activity. So many times you have seen that ambulance of 108 properly located at Ring Road, Ahmedabad. So with the help of this location, 108 easily access any area of the Ahmedabad in internal as well as external. So ambulance management system going to decide their particular location on the Ring Road side, right? So they can access all the city areas around the city, right? So this is the basic location positions of the 108 organizational activity. Now FMS functions, right? So also FMS function directly included in 108 organizational activities, and we had already discussed all FMS functions in previous videos: data collection, systems, identification of numbers, users, mechanical diagnostics, and driver behavior. Now let us discuss fire brigade systems and fire brigade functions. A fire department or fire brigade, also known as a fire protection district, right? And fire authority was also known as a firefighter, fire services, and rescue operations of particular department, right? So which are the services offered by the fire brigade system? First one is the emergency rescue services. Second thing is the fire hazard services. Third one is the emergency medical services. So these three facilities provided by the fire brigade functions, right? And fire departments are mostly common of public organizations who operate within a municipality, particularly country, state, or nationwide, or particularly special district wise, right? Means fire brigade systems run on particularly their basic structure of the nations, right? Like taluka department, then district levels, then state level, and then nationwide. So these are the basic introduction of the fire brigade systems. Now private and most public, both systems can run fire brigade systems in particularly in nations. Now let us discuss the fire brigade function. So first one is the fire brigade function is the fire departments are organized in a system of administration, services, trainings, and operations. Administration is the responsible for the supervision, budget, policy, and human resources, right? So administration is necessary in every system, like ambulance management system, fire brigade system, GSRTC, public transportation system, freight system. In every system, administration is required, right? And it is responsible for supervision, budget, policy, and human resources. It means how many employees are required. Second thing is that which is the budget of the particular financial year, then which are the policies of the systems, and also we are also looking for employees which directly deal to the system, right? So recruitment of the employees and promotion of the employees directly deal with the administration department. Second thing is the service offers protection, safety, and education to the public. That means service is the important parameter of the fire brigade system. This involves protection and safety of the public. Third one is that training prepares skilled people with the knowledge to perform all their duties. See, fire brigades always works in the critical and hazardous conditions. So we have to train people for particularly department, so we can save life and we can eliminate maximum risk and convert into minimum risk. So training prepared skills, people with the knowledge to perform their duties very well. Fourth one is the volunteers. Volunteers give an advantage to the department in the state emergency. Means we have to also market. We have fire brigade department also doing marketing for volunteers too. Prepare in emergencies for cities as well as states. And we can say that volunteer department support the fire brigade systems. And most important thing is that research is give to advantage in new technologies for the department. So we have to do so many kinds of research to enhance the fire brigade vehicles, fire brigade safety, as well as we have to develop some personal protective equipment kits for the firefighters so they can save more life and eliminate maximum risk. So these are the basic introductions of 108 organizational activities and transport management systems of fire brigade. Till date, stay safe and thank you.